spring. Love me some old 73 three-quarter ton Chevy. Well, I was driving by this place and I decided to turn around and I spotted a couple of things back in here. There's a pretty nice old Dodge truck. I spotted something else back here too. I don't know where it is now. Where did it go? That's a pretty cool old truck. What do we got here? Schroeder fuel, oh yeah. It's like an old International. Spotted something else. It was brown, I know that. I don't know what it was exactly. There it is. Huh. Oh, ain't she a beauty? Looks like we got a chop top on that one. I do believe my pants are on fire. Looks like my chair's on fire. I believe my table's on fire. Hey, welcome to Rat Rodding. My name's Waylon Wire, and don't ever do what we do here on this channel. Hey, we got our new crankcase filter. It's at the bottom. We've got three different kinds of PCV valves. This came out of an old 305 block that I've got out back. This came out of Jimmy Hoffa. And these are the brand new ones.
So I'm putting in here.
Don't over tighten the valve covers, especially on the older small block Chevys. Tighten them down too tight, and you bend the metal and squishes the gasket out and then start leaking. I'm telling you what to do. Don't mean to tell you what to do. Sorry I worded it that way. I said don't. What I should have said was I don't. I don't over tighten. So I'll try and tell you how to do your job. I'm telling you how I do mine. Well, I'm just kind of messing around here tonight. I got a little piece of metal I'm rolling out. I got some rot here I got to take out. I don't know if you all can see that or not, but anyway. I got a little piece of metal I'm going to put in there, but here's the deal. A friend of ours out here in Kashmir, guy brought me a whole load of metal. I mean, a load of it. He just kept carrying this stuff in there. All these rods, good nuts and washers and flat pieces of steel and tube steel and channel, and he brought me, well, it just goes on, and there's just some nice shapes and pieces. Bob Grant, what a guy. Just tons of good metal. And then he brought a whole pile of these straps. And all these, I guess the Honda shop, when they get new bikes in, they come strapped down or something. I don't know, but he winds up with this stuff. I was just demonstrating my little shrinker stretcher deal, what it can do. It doesn't take much. At least would shrinker stretcher, I recommend them. They work real well. But not only this, but he bought me a whole trailer load of this. I don't know what you guys are seeing. Yeah, anyway. Yeah, a whole trailer load of this stuff. This box steel. Little square tubing. About 1-inch tubing. And, you know, I use a lot of this stuff. But I got to get it out of here. He just kept making trip after trip and carried it in here. And I'd go, well, what are you doing, Bob? And he just kept unloading stuff. And he finally quit. I talked him into stopping, but... Yeah, out back, we went out and unloaded his trailer. He just brought me a ton of stuff. Good stuff, man. I can use that, a lot of it. Don't know what I'll do with these, but... these straps, but... I don't know. We got them. Thanks, Bob. You're all right, man. I don't care what anybody else says. I don't think you do either. You know, I spent a lot of time cutting the rust out of this old cab, and I normally don't bother with stuff like that because, you know, these old rat rods are rusty sometimes, and most of the time I just leave it that way, but this time I just felt it was necessary. You know, I just had a lot of rot in here, and I just decided to cut it out and replace it with good metal, and I'm not going to paint that or anything. It'll just... rust naturally, and surface rust is fine with me, but I spent a lot of time on this cab, and probably more than I should, but anyway, hopefully I'll make a little progress this week. I hope to get this thing, the rot cut out, and good metal welded in, and then knock some dents out of it, and get on to making cab mounts. But I wanted to mention something. You guys busted me on something in that last video, and you're absolutely right, and boy, I did a big no-no, and I don't know, I just wasn't thinking, you know, which happens a lot around here. A lot of times I'm just not thinking. But I was welder grinding around that windshield on that Jeep, and I should have had that glass covered up, and you're absolutely right. So I messed up big time there, and I own it, you know, I did it. But, you know, if you ever notice the beginning of these videos, it says don't ever do what I do, and you need to take that to heart, because you know, I don't I screw up a lot, but anyway, the windshield's fine. I didn't do that much grinding, and I was going pretty slow and easy, and it's okay, but I was concerned about it. Another thing, I had some guys really worried about me hauling those propane, or not propane, oxyacetylene tanks in the back of my truck, and had some guys really concerned about them hauling them laying down like that. And you know, the good news is I've only been doing that for about 50 years, so maybe we'll be okay on that one. You know, Although this work has been kind of, well, extremely slow and tedious, I really quite enjoyed It's rust repair. Removal, rust removal. Taking a lot of time. But, like I say, it's all about the journey, right? Well, I am kind of done with my rust repair, I think. Yeah, I've got to now knock a few dents out of this thing. Quite a few dents. Quite a few to knock out. Then I'm going to get a brush and I'm going to knock all that loose paint off of there. And then I'm going to set it on. I got one more place to fix right there. I forgot about that. I got to cut that out. Anyway, yeah, I'm almost done with this thing. I'm going to knock the dents out and set it down on the frame and start building cab mounts. Got to get my, I'm a little distracted. Can you tell? Anyway, I've got music going there and I just realized that YouTube ain't going to like that. So, we're going to call this good for now. I'm going to clean up here and I'm going to start beating the dents on this thing. And it's raining today. This is probably the first time it's rained here since long about the 1st of June sometime. First part of June, I believe. I don't know for sure, but it's been a long, dry summer. As they all are here in this part of the world. Well, my little idea of using the brazing rod did not work out too well. It was too hard. And then around across these little screws, these little self-tappers, that would have been okay, but I didn't like the looks of that much. And then I ran onto these guys. Looks like copper. So I suppose those would work. But now we're getting down to the brass tacks right here. There's some. The head's a little bit big on those, but then we got these. These little guys. Whoa. Goodness gracious me. Oh my. Boy, that's exactly what I wanted. Just dump all that. These little guys actually look the most authentic. If I can thread one in there with one hand. Yeah. That looks the most authentic. So I'm gonna go with those if I can. See if I can brad them down on the backside. See what happens. Alright, somebody clean that mess up. Alright. That worked out really well. And they look better than anything else I had tried to do. Look a little more authentic. Yeah, I can live with that. Well, I'm pretty near plumb happy about it. Well, I'm getting pretty good at moving that chassis around. Got a buddy coming up to do the brakes on his. Oh, what did he buy? I think he bought himself a 4Runner. Something like that, but anyway, yeah, I'm gonna get that thing out of the way so he can run it in here and use the lift. I'm getting quite a bit of practice rolling that chassis around. Beat on it, Warren!
I'm a beat on her! All she's doing is smiling!
Boy, them old tight drums don't want to come off. Well, once again, the chassis is back in. And the cab is hanging, and it's hanging in such a way that I can drop it down and build cab mounts. So, yeah, and all the bodywork is done. The rot is gone. And I beat the dents out of the back of the cab as best I could. And I'm not too worried about that. It's just an old truck. But anyway, I've got it hanging so that it doesn't, my straps and my where I hook onto it and everything doesn't interfere with where the mounts are going to go. They'll be on the inside of the frame there. So, yeah, making a little progress. It's been a long time coming to get it to this stage, it seems like. I spent a lot of time on that cab, but it wasn't all that. It was just other things come along, and I couldn't, you know, I didn't work on it full time, and that's okay. I don't have to. It's not going anywhere. But I'm gonna get my cab mounts built. Probably while I'm at it, I'll bolt it down temporarily on the mounts, and then while I'm at it, I will probably set the engine in there and start getting some engine mounts built. And then once that's done, I'll blow it all apart one more time, roll that chassis out at least one more time. Oh, at least one more time I got to blow it apart. That's just all part of the process. All right, I'm going to call tonight. I'm going to quit a little bit early tonight. It's about midnight. It's exactly midnight, actually. So I'm going to shut her down for this evening, and we'll catch you guys on the flip-flop. Well, tis a blustery, windy, but yet beautiful day here on the eastern slopes of the foothills of the mighty Cascade Range. So nice to see the clean air. We had a lot of rain. Helps get the fires contained. Now let's see what's going on in here. I've been working the graveyard shift quite a bit. Swing and graveyard and this is where we are. Yeah, hours and hours and hours it never got on camera, but that's okay. It's done now, and I like it. I'm happy with it. I think everything turned out pretty good. This thing set out in the rain yesterday, and we got a little patina going on there already. A little bit of rust, but it doesn't take long, does it? Yeah, I got the dents beat out of the back of that cab. Warren was here last night, and he helped me with that. Thank you, Warren. You know, I've just got some really, really, really good friends and neighbors and some awesome YouTube subscribers. So I'm going to go ahead and shut up and get busy. This is exciting. It's time to lower that down. And all I wanted to say, you know, some of you will be disappointed that I'm not going to channel that cab down over the frame. And, you know, I'm a little disappointed in that too, but I guess people were smaller back in those days. Or I'm certainly bigger back in these days. But there's not a lot of room in that cab. And if I channel it way down, there's just no leg room. Plus, that transmission is really wide. Takes up a lot of foot space in there. So I'm going to have to leave that cab sitting up on the frame rather than channel down over it. And yeah, that's kind of a disappointment in a way, but still it's a truck, you know, and if we had to climb up into that cab, that would be okay. We won't have to, it's just low enough, but and I'll probably put a running board on there just for looks, but that would be fine if we had to climb up into the cab, because after all it is a truck. We're not building a minivan here. So that's about all I can say about that. It's not going to sit as low as some of us would like, but It's still going to be a beast, and it's going to be fun. So I'm going to get busy. I sure do appreciate y'all coming by. You know, part of the reason that hours and hours of this work on the cab did not get video is because I have the music cranked in my shop most of the time, and YouTube doesn't like that. They frown on that. I've shown this on Instagram, I think, but I don't believe I ever showed my YouTube friends what I found under the seat of this old truck. And this is wonderful. Look at the size of that crank. I had to go through the grill and reach way back in to get that old flathead. And this is I love this thing, man. What a great tool. This is what a wonderful lug wrench. It's got this little tire tool here on the end of it. I just think that's fantastic. Man, they just don't build stuff like that anymore. What a deal. Love this old iron. Can you tell? Man, I could live here. You have to be careful where you take your measuring points from, because you see this sheet metal? It comes down and it's not quite down to the bottom. Let's see if I can get this set up. Yeah, it's not quite a piece of metal from the firewall here. Doesn't come quite down to the bottom of this mounting plate. It's about an eighth of an inch above, maybe a little more. But on the other side, and this is factory, this is nothing I've changed or gotten into, but on this side you can see the same sheet metal hangs down a good quarter inch, about 3/8 down below this mounting plate. Where on the other side it's above it. So yeah, you got to be careful about where you take your measuring points from. It's all good stuff though. Well, guys, that's going to do it for this time. You know, it seems like I didn't make a lot of progress this week. Working on that door was just slow going, and working on the cab was real slow. We were cutting out that rust and replacing the metal. It doesn't seem like a lot of progress, but that's the way it goes sometimes. You know, you work and work and work, and you just don't see much for your efforts, and then you do one thing, and all of a sudden, bam, it looks like you've got a whole lot done. So hopefully that'll happen next week, because I want to set this engine in here and get some motor mounts built. And that might make a bit of difference in the way this thing looks. Matter of fact, I'm pretty sure it's going to make a lot of difference. And I'm looking forward to it. I hope you are too. I appreciate you coming by and spending a little time here with me. And
You know, if you're not subscribed, go ahead and smash that subscribe button. And until next time, I appreciate it.